Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Rock me, Lord, come and easy. I've got a home on the other side. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Rock me, Lord, come and easy. I've got a home on the other side. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Rock me, Lord, come and easy. I've got a home on the other side. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Rock me, come and easy. I've got a home on the other side. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Swing down, cherry stopping, let me ride. Rock me, Lord, come and easy. I got a home on the other side. Swing down, chariot.
Rising Wosay, and welcome all to the community of the Sacred African Way. We're gathered here today to celebrate that way. And today, joining us, leading us in affirmation, is Brother Ed Lucas and Mama Asada Morton. Brother Ed's here, Mama Asada. We'll get started.
Good morning, Wosay family.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good afternoon for some people.
Good afternoon.
Wosay community affirmation. We will know God's truth to be free and self-determined.
Creator, help us to remember the humanity, glory, and suffering of our ancestors and to honor the struggles of our elders.
Let us strive to bring new vision to the life and life to our people. Let there be peace and harmony among us.
Let us be loving, sharing, and creative. Let us work, study, and listen so we may learn, teach, and cultivate self-reliance.
Grant us power, O Holy One, as we struggle to resurrect our hearts and our homeland.
We will raise our children according to the needs of our nation with discipline, patience, devotion, and courage. We will strive to be the living models of the new direction of our people.
We are an African people.
We are children of God.
Ashe.
Ashe. Thank you. Ashe. Now, Baba Jeffrey has a musical treat for us. Baba Jeff?
You all look real good this morning.
Yeah.
Stones of Fire, real, real glad to be here in front of you this morning. And we want to let you know that we feel good too, and that you Africans out there just looking so pretty in your colors. And Brother Tahimba always gets on me about I don't talk enough when it's time for me to do songs. So I'm supposed to stand up here and say, I'm just real glad to be able to do this song. And I want y'all to pray with me in case my voice gets a little crazy. Just say, she's doing the best she can.
That's right, that's right.
All right. Well, I feel good, good, good. Well, I feel good, oh, yes, my Lord. Because there's something about the spirit of Amazon makes me feel good, good, good. Well, I can love, love, love. Well, I can love, oh, yes, my Lord. Because there's something about the spirit of Amazon makes me love good. Good, good. Well, I've got joy, joy, joy. Well, I've got joy down in my soul. Because there's something about the spirit of Amina gives me such joy, joy, joy. Well, I can sing, sing, sing. Well, I can sing, oh, yes, my Lord. Because there's something about the spirit of Amina makes me sing good. Good, good. Well, do you feel good? Good, good. Well, if you feel good, then clap your hands. Because there's something about the spirit of Amina that makes me feel good. Good, good. Well, I feel good. Good, good. Well, I feel good. Oh, yes, my Lord. Because there's something about the spirit of Amina that makes me feel good. Good, good.
Fantastic, Baba Jeff. Thanks so much. Baba Tahimba is here this week. He's going to lead us with a historical tribute. Baba Tahimba?
Good morning, we'll say. Good morning, we'll say. Thank you, Minister Bill. I feel a little funny that I'm here to do one thing, but I'm off the bat, I'm going to ask to do something entirely different. So I'm not going to be able to stay around till the end of service today. And I have an announcement that I would like to make. So I'm wondering, Brother Minister, if I can make that announcement now.
Please proceed.
Thank you very much. And the announcement is for some of, we know Brother Damu Sudi Ali. He's been a resident pianist in the community for years, long time WOSA member, was at one time the leader of the Stones of Fire. He wants us to know, he doesn't want us to know. I want to say that he's been having health issues. He has totally lost his eyesight now, but he is not letting that stop him. So he wants us to know that he has a new CD that's out. It's called Serenity. It will be available soon in Mama Dinesha's store and at Marcus Books. And we'll be able to get it online in a couple weeks. And he wants to know that this Tuesday night, Tuesday, August the 18th, April the 18th, he's going to be on KPFA and he's going to play portions of the CD. So anybody who wants to hear Baba Damu's newest, not his last, but his newest project is welcome to come to KPFA Tuesday. He also wants us to know that his colleague and good friends and somebody many of us know, Paul Tillman Smith, who is the president of the Bay Area Jazz Society, has suffered a massive heart attack. And so he wants us to include the brother Paul Tillman Smith in our prayers. Okay, thank you for that. Now on to what I'm here to do. We have come to that time in our service that we call our historical tribute. It's a time that we will say take out each and every Sunday morning to pay honor, to pay homage, to pay tribute to some significant, not necessarily famous, but some significant person, place, or event in our history. Person, place, event, or organization in our history. And I have the honor and the privilege of presenting this morning's tribute on this very special day. And I want to make sure that so naturally, now my computer's not working.
Says Bobby Ty has started sharing. It'll be here soon, I hope.
Well,
in the meantime, Bobby Ty, do you know the time for Damu's show on Tuesday night?
Yes, I thought it's 2:30 in the afternoon.
Thank you.
Okay, so now I'm getting... Okay, I should see. Normally in the old days, I would have been that.
Maybe we should swing back to Bobby Ty. Bobby, Jeff.
He's gonna log back in.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, his screen was frozen, so I assume that he has to log back in. So let's give him a moment, because ordinarily I would probably do a historical tribute, but this is a long series day, and he has some special content for them.
Sisters and brothers, here he is. He just popped back on. Go ahead, Brother Bill. You just and take yourself off mute, Bobby Ty. Okay. Bobby Ty, you're on mute. You're muted.
There we are.
Are we seeing my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. I don't see my cursor. This is, oh my goodness, this is not what I want. Okay, anyway, let me continue. Wolsey started on December 7th, 1980. That's over 42 years ago. In all of that time, only one member, past or present, has had their portrait. Before I do that, let me go someplace else. I'm sorry. Let me back up a little bit. In those 42 years, only one member of Osei, past or present, has had their portrait on the walls of the Osei sanctuary. There's only one member, past or present, that has a classroom and an entire grade named after them at our school, Ileomide. There's only one person that has not one, but two songs that whenever they are sung at Wosei, we recognize them as her songs. There's only one member of Wosei, past or present, that we recognize, that we remember, and that we honor each and every year with their own day. Mm-hmm. And that day has been celebrated in Wosei, Oakland, for over 25 years. Every year for over 25 years, we have had... Imama Jaisiri Day. She's the sister that you heard sing the opening song that Jeff played. And she's also the sister that you just heard talk and sing with us. And on this day, I am privileged to do the tribute to Mama Jaisiri. Okay. Now, before I start, I do want to give a heartfelt thanks to two brothers who have made this tribute possible this morning. I first say thank you to you, Minister Bill. Minister Bill, it was your understanding and your leadership that got Mama Jaisiri Day put back on the Wosei schedule, and I thank you immensely for that. The second person is Baba Jeff, who worked countless hours and put in a tremendous amount of effort to make the video that I'm about to show showable to you. Okay, both these brothers, along with Minister Imhotep, worked tirelessly behind the scenes week after week week in and week out to make sure that the Bose Sunday service comes off smoothly and efficiently. Mm-hmm. You know, these brothers are treasures in our community. We need to recognize that and them. We need to thank God for their existence. We need to forgive whatever small mistakes they make, and we need to appreciate them to no end. But I digress. Let me come. This tribute is about Mama Jassiri, so let me go back to Mama Jassiri. Okay, I'm not going to say much about Mama Jassiri. Instead, I'm going to let her present herself in these never-before-seen videos.
Mm.
Well, wait a minute. That might be a little dramatic. I'm sure someone has seen these videos before. But what I know is that they have never before been played at a Wose service, not in a live service or on a Zoom service. Mama Jassiri was a little woman. You know, she was small in stature, but she had a very powerful and beautiful smile, a very powerful and beautiful love, and a very powerful and beautiful personality that affected everyone that ever came within her presence.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't really run anything at Wose, but she was a part of everything. Now, I don't know that she's ever been compared to Reggie Jackson. You know, Reggie Jackson, the giant of a man baseball player who hit home runs for the New York Yankees and for the Oakland A's. But I'm going to compare Mama Jassiri in a way to Reggie Jackson. You know, Reggie Jackson, when he played for the New York Yankees, called himself the straw that stirred the drink, right? At Wose, Mama Jassiri was the straw that stirred the drink. Now, if I'm going to be true and honest with this analogy, Minister Makalisi made the drinks, he poured the drinks, and he cleaned up after the drinks were finished. But Mama Jassiri was the straw that stirred that drink.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for those who knew Mama Jassiri, and even for those of you who didn't, I have a treat. I'm going to play a video that features Mama Jassiri saying a poem. The video was the early 1990s at a jazz and arts festival, which was a Wose sponsored event. Unfortunately, the sound quality is not great, and you have to listen very carefully to hear. Also, this video holds a surprise for one of you in the audience. So if you let me, I'm going to have to go out and come back in and to share this video. And I am having a problem with my cursor. Here we go. Okay. Can we see the video? Are you seeing this? Yes.
I see Mama Jassiri on screen.
Can you see that?
And I hear some music coming up.
Do you see it?
We can see the listing on the side, but not.
You have to minimize. You have to minimize. You have to minimize the Mama Jassiri picture.
Okay. Come back at this.
Mm-hmm.
Now you sing the video.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Fire would like to make a dedication to John Coltrane.
Mm. Supreme, a love supreme.
We hope you have enjoyed this.
A love supreme.
His horn blew, my favorite thing. He gave
That was Mama Jessie. And for those who know her, who were around then, you saw that there were two ancestors next to her, Sister Teresa Lewis and Sister Harvetta Bonar. And on the other side, there was another ancestor, Baba Lee Donald. Okay. And the surprise is that poem was written by my dear friend and the woman that I consider the new mother of the reparations movement in America, my lifelong buddy, Sister Nakishi Taifa, who's with us today. Sister Nakishi, I don't know if you've ever heard that before, but I want you to know that the Stones of Fire did your, we do your poetry. You know, we actually did. Malcolm X was a strong Black man. Malcolm X said the struggle was for the land. Self-determination for Black people now by any means necessary was his. So we do your music, my sister. And I want you to know, Nakishi, that in many ways, you embody Mama Jaisiri. You are a woman small in stature with a big, beautiful smile, a big, beautiful personality, and a big, beautiful love for our people. You are a treasure, you know, not just to the Wolsey community, but to us nationally. You are, in my opinion, the straw that stirs the drink of our reparations movement in America now. So I thank you, Sister Nakishi, but I digress. I have to move on. But before I let you go, let me say to you, give your beautiful and talented daughter, Amma, tell Baba Tai says hello. All right. So moving on, I do have one more video.
And today's her birthday, Ty.
And today is Mama Jaisiri's birthday.
Today's my daughter's birthday also.
And it's also Jaisiri.
So she was born on Mama Jaisiri Day. Wow, that is even more special. That's
amazing, right? Okay, I do want to show one more video. Go back to this. Now this video is Mama Jaisiri singing one of her signature songs. Are we seeing the video?
Not yet.
Okay, let me go back here. I used to do this every Sunday at Wolsey, and now that I've been gone, I can't figure it out.
Those memories fade quickly,
yes. Okay, start screen share. Are we seeing it now?
Not yet.
Now? But
the music started. Maybe it's in another window. Can't
see it. You heard the music, but you can't see it.
Correct.
Okay, let me try one more time. Okay. Now you see a microphone.
Yes.
Okay, so let me say again that this song is Mama Jaisiri singing one of her signature songs. And there is a surprise in this video. Minister Makalisi, there is a surprise in this video for you. So I want you to look out for the surprise. Before I play this tribute, let me say that at the conclusion of my tribute, Baba Jeff is going to play another song that opens with Sister Akanke, who can't be here today. Akanke is actually out of the country as we speak, so she can't be here today. But Baba Jeff's going to play a song with Akanke talking about her best friend, Mama Jaisiri. And then we will sing, the Stones of Fire will sing another one of Mama Jaisiri's signature songs. Okay, and then I'm going to come back and say a little after the song. Anyway, here is Mama Jaisiri.
Baba Tai, could you set that to full screen mode?
You know, I tried, but it's not working for some reason.
Oh, okay. I see.
That is my, it's, oh, well. It says it is there my it is. I'm okay. Sorry. So anyway, here's Mama Jaisiri.
Thank you.
Oh, yes, I am.
I am so thankful to be African, and you should be too. Mama Jasiri wrote that song. Let me do one more thing here real quick. I think you're seeing my screen. Anyway, this concludes my presentation. Mama Jasiri, we love you, and your presence is still felt in the Bosse community. May your name live. May your spirit dwell, and may your presence continue to be felt and be a power in the hearts and the minds of our people, especially here in the Bosse community, forever and forever and forever. Happy birthday, Mama Jasiri. Happy birthday, Ama Taifa. And thank you, Bosse.
Ashe, thank you.
Ashe.
Beautiful. Happy birthday, Sister Jasiri.
This song that we're going to give you as a gift, it was a song that was written for our Mama Jasiri. When Mama Jasiri started her preschool class, she always grounded the children because she said that we don't know what situation our children are coming from. We don't know what their morning has been like. We don't know what their evening was like before they went to sleep. So they always began with prayer and meditation, which was part of their everyday teaching. So this song really embodies everything that she stood for us, everything that Mama Oyin and Mama Okanona had in mind when Iliomo Day was started 25 years ago. Let us celebrate. This is not something that's going on every day, everywhere. Let us celebrate. We've done something monumental. Yes. We have children that go to Laney College for advanced math. Yes. Come on now, y'all. That's not happening everywhere. We have 12th graders in some school that's not producing fifth grade work. Come on, y'all. Let us celebrate and let us not forget to work. These doors are always open for you to come and help. So in the spirit of Mama Jasiri and all of our teachers, we give this gift to you.
Teach the children what they need to survive. Don't let them be misled by the same old lies. Only time will tell, only time will tell. If we've taught them well, like we should know by now, some way, somehow, we've gotta teach the children.
Don't you know we have to educate the children, the children. If the world you want to liberate, don't you know you have to educate
the children,
the children.
Teach the children that for truth they must take a stand. Ooh. To fight against all oppression. Ooh. And help their fellow man. Only time will tell, only time will tell. If we taught them well, like we should know by now. Some way, somehow, we've got to teach the children. Come on, y'all. Educate
the children.
Take the time to educate the children.
The children.
Teach the children what it means to be free. See, only unshackled minds can break the chains of slavery. Only time will tell, only time will tell. If we've taught them well, like we should know by now. Someday, somehow, to teach the children.
The world you want to liberate, don't you know you have to
educate the children?
The children.
Oh, if the world.
Don't you know you have to
take the time and educate
the children?
Oh, teach the children what they need to survive. Don't let them be misled by the same old lies. Only time will tell. If we taught them well, like we should know.
Now,
some way, somehow, gotta teach the children.
If the world you want to liberate, don't you know you have to educate
singing,
the children.
Stir the fire, sing it for me.
If the world you want to liberate,
tell them now.
Don't you know you have to
educate the children.
The children.
If the world.
If the world
children. Educate the children. Oh,
if the world you want to liberate,
if the world,
all you have to educate,
take the time.
The children.
The children.
If the world you want to liberate, don't you know you have to educate the children.
Fantastic. Yes, that's exactly what Baba Tai meant.
Awesome.
Beautiful voices.
Awesome.
Beautiful people brought together by a master videographer, Baba Jeffrey Moore. And now we are pressing on with our litany of sacrifice. Sister Michelle and Baba Damani are going to lead us.
Good morning, World's A family, grand rising to everybody. And it's a part in our service when we, what I call the rubber meets the road, where we get to make sure our two churches are financially solvent. Anyway, waiting for the screen. Shit, build upon the screen. Here we go. Litany of sacrifice. Save us, O Holy One, by your name. Vindicate us by your might. Hear my prayer, divine protector. Listen to the words of my mouth. How can we repay the Holy One for the gifts that we have been given to us? We will lift up the cup of salvation and call upon the God of our ancestors. We will fill our vows to our Creator in the presence of all our people. Gladly we bring our sacrifices to you. We praise your name, O Amun-Ra, for it is good. Emoji, unity. We should strive to maintain unity in family, community, nation, and race.
Uji Chagalia, self-determination. We shall define, name, create, and speak for ourselves.
Yajima, collective work and responsibility. We shall build and maintain our communities together. Our brothers and sisters' problem shall be ours to solve together.
Ujamaa, cooperative economics. Together we shall build and maintain our own businesses and together profit from them.
Nia, purpose. We shall make our collective vocation the building and developing of our community and the restoration of our people to our traditional greatness.
Kuumba, creativity. We shall do as much as we can in any way we can to leave our community more beautiful and beneficial than when we inherited it.
Amani, faith. We will believe with all our hearts in our God, our people.
And in the righteousness and victory of our struggle.
Ashe.
Ashe. If you notice.
Okay, real fast on the screen is two ways you can send your money to send your donations into Wolse Community Church in Sacramento and Oakland. You can use snail mail or you can click on the website. You know, everybody should be familiar with that by now. Anyway.
All right. Thank you, Damani. If we could just take a moment and bow our head in prayer. Oh, Mother, Father, God, she who is of the Most High, the maker of all that is and shall be, the giver of all our needs, the knower of what is beyond truth. Oh, Holy One, we are here to pledge our sacrifice to you. And I thank all of those today who will give. And I thank those who promise to give in the coming days to our church. I ask Most High to bless everyone here today because sacrifice is a part of the way, is a part of Ma'at. Please grant us the wisdom in understanding the place sacrifice should hold in our lives. O Amun-Ra, let us understand that sacrifice is a tool that mends faith, reverses wrong deeds, keeps the church doors open, and sacrifice always helps to support our community. Sacrifice is a part of life and mindful actions of a righteous woman, of a righteous man. The Nguzo Sapa cannot come to live within us without sacrifice. And often, if we think about it, giving to another, sacrificing for another's cause, it brings out the good in us, even though it may cause us some pain. Whether the pain be physical or a reduction in our funds or possessions, we are willing to bear that pain that comes with sacrifice. That pain is our badge of faith. Faith that we could make a positive change through the lessening of ourselves. The quieting of ourselves comes with sacrifice. If you think about it, our vessel of knowledge grows with sacrifice. One must empty the vessel of the waters of life before you can fill it again with more of that water. Sacrifice, the litany of sacrifice, is a tool, a necessary action for us to remain on the path of the way. I hope this prayer moves you to seek out those quiet times, to tighten your fortress, and find ways to take those small stones in your life and give it to build the spiritual ladder of faith in Wosei and the physical walls of Wosei Community Church. Amen, Amun-Ra, Ashe.
Ashe. Thank you, Sister Michelle. Now, bring forward with our message for today, young Minister Imhotep. Venerable Minister Imhotep, please step forward.
Tee-hee.
Yeah, you're almost as old as me now.
Yeah, you know, when I first started, that's what they used to say. They say, now here's young brother Imhotep back in 1980, 81, 82. Remember that, Baba Kofi? They used to say that, but they don't say it anymore. Anyway, glad to see everyone this morning. We had, at one point, we had 50 people on here. That's a good turnout. Right now we have 48. I'm looking forward to that. So our message today, just for a few minutes, and you know, when ministers say that, it's going to be a while. So just let you know. So I want to share this this screen with you, and we're going to talk about woke today. Our message is going to be talking about woke.
And you know I can't use that word in Florida.
That's right. Sorry about that, man. You know, just, you know. Yeah, so woke. Let's open up with a little Bob. You can follow along.
So when you're riding through the ruts, don't got to be done, so let's do it a little by a little.
So a little Bob, a Wake Up and Live, our freedom writings will come from the Hosea, Ptahotep, number 21, page 48, and 2000 Seasons in the prologue, page 13. If a son or daughter accepts the righteous teachings of their parents, none of their plans will go wrong. Teach your children, then, to be those who hear well. They will be valued by those of weight and substance, and their speech will be informed by what they have heard. Respected are those who listen well. They will excel, and their deeds will distinguish them, but failure will follow those who hear not. And the key sentence of in this passage today, sisters and brothers, is the wise wake early in order to establish themselves, but fools always fail to rise at the opportune time. The wise wake early in order to establish themselves, but fools always fail to rise at the opportune time. And in 2000 Seasons, we find these words: the linking of those gone, ourselves here, those coming, our continuation, our flowing, not along any matriculous channel, but along our living way, the way. It is that remembrance that calls us. The eyes of the seer should range far into purposes. The ears of the hearer should listen far towards origin. The utterer's voice should make knowledge of the way, of heard sounds and vision seen. The voice of the utterers should make this knowledge inevitable, impossible to lose. Respected are those who hear well. Mama Connie, this is from the Purba, or the Temple of Kaumbo, in near Aswan. And I took this picture because it has the ears and the eyes. You know, you've heard that phrase, the ears have walls. And in our freedom rights, it says, respected are those who listen well. Some of you may have read some George Orwell, This is one of his quotes. He says, whoever controls the image and information of the past determines what and how future generations will think. Whoever controls the information and images of the present determines how those same people will view the past. He who controls the past controls the future. He who commands the future conquers the present. Let's just look at that for a minute. Whoever controls the image and information of the past determines what and how future generations will think. Whoever controls the information and images of the present determines how those same people will view the past. He who controls the past controls the future. He who commands the future conquers the past. George Orwell. So, to some, woke is now a derisive stand-in for diversity, inclusion, empathy, and yes, blackness. So when legislators pass a law to stop woke, in light of the word's true history, as well as its commonly understood meaning, what are they saying? The phrase or word woke. You know, I used to think that woke was a new term for what we used to call conscious. You know, we would say in the 80s and 90s, and yes, even in the 2000s beginning, we would talk about the conscious community. When Dr. Ben came to WOSAY, it was announcing to the conscious community, this is where you could come to get some spiritual uplift, some information, some knowledge about yourself. But as it turns out, this phrase goes back a while. In 1971, the phrase was used in a play by American playwright Barry Beckham, titled Garvey Lives, in which he wrote, I've been sleeping all my life, and now that Mr. Garvey done woke me up, I'm gonna stay woke, and I'm gonna help him wake up other Black folk. That was in 1971, and I know if Judy is on, I know Judy, you weren't born then, but it happened in 1971. But it turns out that there's a whole timeline of the word woke. 1923, a collection of aphorisms and the ideals by the Jamaican philosopher and social activist Marcus Garvey included the sums, wake up Ethiopia, wake up Africa. Can anybody name me this collection of aphorisms that they're talking about? Anybody know what that is? Anybody? Can't hear you.
Philosophy and Opinions of Marcus Garvey.
That's right, Sister Keisha. Thank you. Thank you. So in 1923, they're talking about waking up Ethiopia. Ethiopia means people of burnt skin. Wake up Africa. And then in 1938, blues musician Huddy Ledbetter, known as Lead Belly, uses the phrase stay woke in his song Scottsboro Boys. We're going to come back to the Scottsboro Boys. In 1940, the Negro United Mine Workers launch a strike in West Virginia against discriminatory pay. A Black union leader speaks about learning they were being paid less than their white counterparts. He says, "We were asleep, but we will stay woke from now on." That's for those of you, Sugar D and Minister Mockley's in Virginia. Well, West Virginia is close by you. In 1962, in an article, in an essay in the New York Times, "We're Woke, You Dig?" written by William Melvin Kelly. And then in 1972, Barry Beckham uses the word woke in his 1972 play, Garvey Lives. There's a whole timeline. Oh, what happened here? Yeah, 1920, goes all the way back to 1923, the philosophies and opinions of the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. And then in 1940, they're using it again when they find out that they're getting paid less than the white workers in the mines. And when they found out, they said, "We were asleep, but we're gonna stay woke from now on." And then in 2008, Niecy, Erykah Badu wrote a song, Master Teacher, and she uses the lyrics, "Stay woke." And then in 2010, woke undergoes a delusion and starts being used broadly as a catch-all to describe social injustice. It quickly becomes appropriated and transformed into a negative descriptor for anything having to do with inclusivity and anti-discrimination. That's how they do. They take your words and turn them around. That's what they do with our vocabulary, with our vernacular. They take our words and use it against us. And then on Jeopardy, the appearance of Stay Woke was a category in 2017. Hulu had a comedy series, 2020, Woke, it premieres. And Florida, sorry, Minister Bill, but in 2022, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis signs into law Stop Woke. They have to do something to stop woke. I was listening to Dr. Malefi Asante, and he pointed out how when Florida was being formed, the state of Florida, white men were given 162 acres for each Native American that they kill. That's why you have to stop woke, because if you don't stop it, then people will realize what happened to them. If you're woke, you dig it? So now let's look at this for a second, a minute. 1938. Blues musician Huddy Ledbetter, better known as Lead Belly, uses the phrase "stay woke" in his song by the Scottsboro Boys. Anybody know that story? The Scottsboro Boys were 9 Black teenagers falsely accused of raping 2 white women aboard a train near Scottsboro, Alabama, 1931. The trials and repeated trials of the Scottsboro Boys sparked an international uproar and produced 2 landmark U.S. Supreme Court verdicts, even as the defendants were forced to spend years battling the courts and enduring the harsh conditions of the Alabama prison system. Here's a song by Ledbetter.
No, I think the Scottsboro Boys. And tell something about how you came to make up that song. And you know the Scottsboro Boys, don't you? Haven't you met them? Tell who they were and what their case was and how you met them.
Yes, ma'am. Miss, I'll tell you all about the Scottsboro Boys because we had a sale once. And the Scottsboro Boys both got out and down that hard world. That Alabama's a hard world down there. And the Scottsboro Boys had a long time, 6 years that time, them four boys what got out. And I met them, and the boys had such a hard time, and I've been through down in that that hard world, but I didn't stay long. And when I saw the Scottsboro Boys, I shook their hand again and thinking about, and hear what I said about the Scottsboro Boys, because I know they had a hard time. And here the advice I give Joe Lewis, and this is the advice I give to all the Harlem colored people, and what I mean all the good colored people. Oh, the Alabama, and you better watch out. The landlord will get you gonna jump and shout. Gospel boys, they can tell you what it's all about. Cause them landlords, if they get you, boy, they're gonna hang you. Oh, the Alabama, and you better watch out. The landlord will get you gonna jump and shout. Gospel boys, tell you what it's all about. I'm gonna talk to a jeweler. Central is anchor me. Don't he never try to make nobody in Alabama ring. Oh, the Alabama, and you better watch out. The landlord gets you gonna jump and shout. Gospel boys, hey, what it's all about. Oh, the Alabama, and you better watch out. The landlord gets you gonna jump and shout. Gospel boys, hey, what it's all about. I'm gonna tell all the colored people they've been on Sugar Hill. Don't you never go to Alabama to try to live. Oh, the Alabama, and you better watch out. The landlord will get you gonna jump and shout. Gospel boys, hear what it's all about. Oh, the Alabama, and you better watch out. The landlord will get you gonna jump and shout. Gospel boys, hear what it's all about. Beat it out. Do it again, didn't understand you.
Get the idea. So these were the Scottsboro Boys. They were hobos, and they were on a train, and there was some white teenagers on that train that were hobos, and they tried to intimidate these guys, and they drove the white boys off. And then they were accused. This is a key thing. This seems to be a theme. They were accused of raping a white woman. And it took years for them to, one died, one got shot in prison. This brother here, Clarence Norris, finally got a pardon from all people, George Wallace. And look how long it, so 1938 to 2013, the Alabama Board of Pardons voted to parole them. That's what the Scottsboro Boys. We need to not forget the Scottsboro Boys, because they're getting ready to take us back to those times. And really, we never left those times. Are you woke today? We'll say.
Yes.
Teach, brother, teach.
I say.
And eventually, the white women recanted their claim of rape. It never happened. But look at these young brothers. Look at how young they were. And this is a National Guard. They had to call out the National Guard to keep them from getting lynched. Uh-oh, moving up in time, the Central Park Five. We don't really know that much. We hadn't really dwelt on Central Park Five that much on the West Coast. You know, we heard about it. And this blood clot, this evil man wanted to get them the death penalty, took out a full page ad in the New York Times newspaper, spent like $200,000. Years later, 10, 11, 13 years later, DNA exonerated them. And this blood clot is a Rasta term. It means instead of being born of an ovum, you are born of a blood clot, like you are phlebitis, that you're blocking the path of righteousness. This blood clot won't even admit to this day that these brothers were innocent. Had nothing to do with them. The police forced them to get confessions, kept them away from their parents. And then when their parents were allowed in, they encouraged their parents to tell them to confess to a crime they didn't commit. Are you woke today? You better pay attention. Now, the next bit of information is coming from the Legal Defense Fund, and it asks questions about critical race theory. This is another term that's out there. I don't think we spend enough time looking at to help you learn more about critical race theory. Legal LDF has compiled answers to most frequently asked questions about it. This resource also includes information on the laws banning racial justice discourse being acted across the country and how they fit into a larger effort to suppress the voice, the history, and political participation of Black Americans. You can go to this website. You can go to this website here, or just search on this. Critical Race Theory, Legal Defense Fund, and you'll find it. So, what is critical race theory? Critical race theory, or CRT, is an academic legal framework that denotes the systematic racism is part of American society. Whoa, really? I had no idea. Racism, a part of American society? Why did somebody tell me? So it's part of American society. From education and housing to employment to healthcare. My God, really? Critical race theory recognizes that racism is more than the result of individual bias and prejudice. It is embedded in laws, policies, institutions that uphold and reproduce racial inequalities. According to CRT, societal issues like Black Americans' higher mortality rate, outsized exposure to police violence, the school to prison pipeline, denial of affordable housing, and the rates of death of Black women in childbirth are not unrelated abnormalities. This is what you need to think about when they bring up the term critical race theory. This is a whole coochie chocolatia, define, name, create, speak for ourselves, to talk about. These aren't just some kind of odd things that just came up. This is a systematic thing. Who created critical race theory? Critical race theory was first developed by legal scholars in the 70s and 80s following the civil rights movement. It was in part a response to the notion that society and institutions were colorblind. CRT holds that racism was not and has never been eradicated from our laws, policies, or institutions, and is still woven into the fabric of their existence. Why should I care about race? Critical race theory. Critical race theory should be embraced as a framework to develop laws and policy that can dismantle structural inequalities, systematic racism. Building a more equitable future requires an examination of how the shameful history of slavery, caste, systematic racism were the foundation to laws and institutions that exists today. Why do some lawmakers want to ban critical race theory? The term critical race theory has been co-opted by opponents as a catch-all and rallying cry to silence any discussion about systematic racism, ban the truthful teachings of American history, and reverse progress towards racial justice. The term has been unjustifiably used to include all diversity and inclusion efforts, race consciousness policies, education about racism, whether or not they draw from CRT. Attempts to ban CRT are really attacks on free speech, on discussions about truthful history of race and racism in the United States and lived experiences of Black people and other people of color. Lawmakers and proponents of bans insist that they are advocating for a balanced and patriotic. This is what they use to us. They they're not trying to do racism. They're just trying to do a balanced and patriotic education. However, these bans do the exact opposite. They deny the truth about our nation's history, silence dissent, and punish those who speak the truth to counter whitewashed falsehoods. Let's just keep going. All right, you can get this later. We don't have much time. I want to get you out at a decent time. Another thing this blood clot did. Do you know his name is not really Trump? It's Drump. His grandfather changed it. His name is really Drump. But see, he's against the 1619 Project. 1619 Project doesn't tell all of our history, but at least it's a start. Of course, he's against it. And you have some stupid, ignorant, blood clot Negroes that are saying Negroes for Trump. I have a friend, he just passed away. My dear friend, Alan Cleveland. And as a joke, when you'd call his house, he'd pick up the phone and he would say, Negroes for Trump. And so I start adopting that too. But you know, there are some real Negroes for Trump out there. And I just pray that the Most High, will turn them around, will have them repent and get the true spirituality of Black people in this country. You know, things are going on right now. Arkansas moves to repeal decades of decades-old discrimination matters. Let me see if I can find that article just for a moment, just to show you. Let's see. Oh, that's not it. Okay. Let's see.
Isn't it already on the screen?
Is it? Let's see.
Back up. Yeah.
I you know what? I had this is what happens when I get all worked up, sisters and brothers. I'm just really vexed today. Anyway, go to Raw Story or just search for this. Arkansas moves to repeal decades. Arkansas moves to repeal decades old desegregation measures. Report, and then ban books, move to center stage in red state. They want to ban books. You know, we thought that we were beyond that. But they made a movie years ago, and it was called The Empire Strikes Back. And this is what is happening. The empire is striking back. And so we have to stay woke. Some people use the word woke as if it's supposed to be an insult, but mostly they use it because they can't spell emphatic, empathetic rather, educated, or enlightened. So they use a term to insult you. Well, you're just part of the woke community. Well, no, that means that I'm educated or I'm enlightened. Our freedom writings, just to return to them as we close. The wise, let's just focus on this last sentence. The wise wake early in order to establish themselves, but fools always fail to rise at the opportune time. The linking, and from 2000 seasons, the linking of those gone, ourselves here, those coming, our continuation, our flowing, not along any matriculous channel, but along our living way, the way. It is that remembrance that calls us. The eyes of the seers should range far into purpose. I'm talking to you circle leaders today. I'm talking to you commission leaders. The eyes, I'm talking to you ministers. The eyes of the seers should range far into purposes. The ears of the hearers should listen far towards origins. The utter's voice should make knowledge of the way, of heard sounds, of vision seen. The voice of the utterers should make this knowledge inevitable, impossible to lose. Wake up!
please wake up.
And on this picture, I didn't show it because the first time I showed it was cropped, but here at the top is Mott of our seeing and our hearing. There's Mott on the top. Wake up. I should. Right now, we're going to, before Minister Alicia gives us the invitation, I want, as we're coming, you know, it's also Olda Ramey's birthday today. Olda Ramey, Olda Ramey,
Gary's
birthday.
Yes.
Today. And Olda Ramey is singing this song. This is an invitational song. We hope that it will inspire you to join today. But here's the invitational song that Olda used to sing a lot of times on those Galindo Street days. And Minister Alicia, you can extend the invitation as we're.
Yes.
If you would like to join, we'll say, please put your hand up. Please write your name in the chat. Please connect with someone that you see on here. Maybe you know someone. Tell them, I would like to join. Maybe you're shy. It's just fine. Any way that you would like to join, we'll say. If Minister Imhotep woke you up today, as you wipe your eyes from the sleep, go ahead and raise your hand. It's all right. Mr. Imhotep told us, you know, to wake up. The wise wake up early. And if you want some time to think about it, go to willsaysac.org or willsaycommunitychurch.org and you can find out ways to join or you can connect with one of us. So I'm gonna take a quick view in the gallery to see if I see any hands up. And as I do not see any hands up today, I would just, you know, tell you, if you're still thinking about it, we'll be here.
Minister Alicia, most people on here are already members.
But what I want
to say to you is reach out to your friends.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to people that we, and this is what we need to be working on this year and the year to come. We look at me, okay, I'm old Minister Imhotep. I'm not young Minister Imhotep, you know. Kat, you didn't know I had this thing. So we need to get some young people in here. We need to figure out how we can get younger people to be part of the Sacred African Way that will continue the work that we started. This is what we need to be doing. I didn't come here to preach you today, but you know, we need to do that. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking.
Minister Imhotep, could I add something to that?
Okay.
We also, this is, you know, the feminine energy is coming into the universe now. So we need to also think about strong leadership. Maybe the next leader of WALSE needs to be a woman. You know, we're not afraid of that, I hope. You know, there are some, you know, we have strong, we definitely have a strong female minister, got it all together. Administrative skills, executive skills, intelligence and organizational skills. And she really would represent, well, say out publicly, a public speaker. And I just think, I just had to put that out there. Maybe it's time for WALSE to be led by a powerful woman.
WALSE is led by the Council of Elders, the minister or the lead minister is just a part of that group, okay? And things are run by that. It's not like the traditional church where there's one minister and there's you know, thus saith this speaking in cathedra, but it is us working together. So it's open for women, it's open for men. It's open for sisters, it's open for brothers. It's open for people that are committed to our movement, who are not here today and gone tomorrow. I heard my wife talking and she was telling somebody about my grandmother's old saying. And one of my grandmother's old saying, Nancy Everlene Parkinson used to say, you can't have hydrant love. You know, which means you can't go in and turn it all on and off, that it has to continually be going, continually. Me and my wife, I don't know why I'm saying this, but we wake up talking WALSE.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we turn over, we're talking WALSE. Uh-oh, she's on now. You're muted. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, I try to limit him where he doesn't start until 5 a.m. And he usually stops at around 1 a.m.
Well, you know, that's the kind of passion and dedication that we need. And I think Minister Imhotep sets the standard for the type of WALSE leader that is to come, you know. And so whenever we select a new minister at WALSE Oakland, it would be somewhat based on the standard that he's set and he's laid down. And so our expectations are high, and we have not rushed to install a lead minister. And we will be having more to say about that later, as well as other things. The minister's message was powerful. It was right on point about waking up, and here at the WALSE community, coming from the Council of Elders, we're working on strategies and goals for this year. And we're going to need all of you all to help us implement those goals and strategies. So we'll be planning on having some conversations in a few weeks where we want everybody in the community to come out or to hang around and share with us as we lay out these goals and strategies for the for this year.
And greetings, everyone. This is Mama Angina. It's important here, I will say, like Baba Imhotep said, it's not a one person leadership. We don't need one person. We need work together with the community. We do not need one person, by no means. Male or female, we need both.
And we do have wonderful participation by women who are very active in WOSE. And remember that the person we're giving tribute to today started Ile Omode. So we have wonderful, wonderful contributions and minister leadership by women within WOSE. And all right. The men do a wonderful job too.
We need workers. People Bill, to work.
Jeff, would you turn on the music? We haven't ended service yet.
As Minister Imhotep said, we're led by our council, and yes. I'm sure the council would welcome all the new energy to complete the work that needs to be done, including deciding who is to be in which position doing that work. Mm-hmm. So please contact anyone on the council, come and make your voice heard.
Mm-hmm. Do the work.
In the meantime, Baba Jeff, you have some more music for us?
Every voice and sing, tell let them ever ring, rich with the harmonies of liberty. Let them rejoice in Christ, high as the listening star.
Now unto the ones who is able to lift us up, faultless before the throne on high, may they empower us to be one people.
One people.
One people.
One aim.
One aim.
One destiny.
One destiny.
One destiny. One love.
One love.
One love. One heart.
One heart.
One God. And let us call upon the name of that one God as our ancestors and the elders have been doing countless times and for time immemorial. Let us all say,
Amen.
Ashe.
You are the most beautiful people.
We are the most beautiful people
of this earth.
Ashe, happy birthday to those who were born on this beautiful day.
Ashe.